The woman's wisdom defeated God. I'd like to start this video by presenting this noble verse from the noble Quran. Do they not ponder on the Quran? Had it been from other than Allah, they would surely have found many discrepancies. The noble Quran, 482. Below we will see the overwhelming amount of corruption in the New Testament. The woman's wisdom defeated God, also known as Jesus. A Canaanite woman from that vicinity came to him, crying out, "Lord, Son of David, have mercy on me. My daughter is suffering terribly from demon possession." Jesus did not answer a word. So his disciples came to him and urged him, "Send her away, for she keeps crying out after us." Jesus answered, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of Israel." The woman came and knelt before him. "Lord, help me," she said. Jesus replied, "It is not right to take the children's dues bread blessings and miracles reserved for them and toss it to their dogs the Gentiles." "Yes, Lord," she said, "but even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table." Then Jesus answered, "Woman, you have great faith. Your request is granted." And her daughter was healed from that very hour. From the NIV Bible, Matthew 15:22-28, it's funny how Jesus, supposedly in the book of manufactured alterations and corruption, the New Testament, instantaneously abrogated his views and decision about the non-Jewish woman and people, in general, being equivalent to dogs when compared to the Jews. It is important to note that the woman in this corrupted book, from the very start, showed that she is a believer, whatever that meant back then. So it wasn't a matter of a disbeliever or pagan seeking Jesus' help. The woman's wisdom defeated Jesus, the so-called creator of the universe. Jesus, within a second, changed his racist and trash-mouthed views against her from being a dog to a human being who deserves to be helped. "I was sent only to," clearly and irrefutably means that Jesus initially claimed that he wasn't sent to other than the Jews. So what if the woman failed with Jesus? It seems that Jesus in the corrupted book of the New Testament changed his racist and filthy views only because the woman begged him. I wonder if the woman never did this and instead answered him inappropriately after he called her and all Gentiles dogs. Would the Gentiles today still be considered as the Jews' dogs? Most probably yes. It doesn't take much for a racist to go back to his old habits and generalize evil beliefs. Again, don't forget that the woman initially showed a believer. Jesus rejected her only because she was a Gentile. The contradiction and manufactured corruption in the text are apparent. The Jesus of the corrupted book of the New Testament is not the creator of the universe, as the lie of Trinity claims. Allow me to quote Jesus himself, or what's put on his mouth, regarding those so-called masters: "O Jerusalem, Jerusalem, you who kill the prophets and stone those sent to you, how often I have longed to gather your children together, as a hen gathers her chicks under her wings, but you are not willing." From the NIV Bible, Matthew 23:37, "No prophet's killers can ever be better than any human being that God Almighty created. Those so-called masters cannot be better than anyone or any race that exists on earth. The dung that I personally or anyone flush in the toilet is better than them." And those worthless words that were uttered on the tongue of Jesus in the book of racism and lies, the New Testament. Let alone them being the masters. So much for them being better than me, a non-Jew, and me being their dog. Because the Bible is not divine and is filled with man's lies, it is easy to find unanswerable contradictions. Jesus' views were absurd and, allow me to say, stupid. At one point, the Jews were the masters, and because he was satisfied with them, he ignored the fact that they were the prophets' killers.
But after they disappointed him, the balance changed, and they became terrible, and it was now okay to go and preach to the Gentiles, the non-Jews. So, in other words, one, have the Jews been okay with Jesus, the Gentiles would not have received any preaching.
Two, the face of Christianity today would be different. Christianity today would be limited to only the lost sheep of Israel, i.e., the Jews. 3, as I mentioned above, have the woman failed with Jesus, the Gentiles today would still be considered the Jews' dogs. Of course, as a Muslim, I don't believe that the foul dirt put on Jesus' mouth or anything that exists in the NT is divine. Again, as Allah Almighty said, do they not ponder on the Quran? Had it been from other than Allah, they would surely have found therein much discrepancy. Only the verses in the Bible and Hadiths, collection of Prophet Muhammad's, peace be upon him, words, that directly agree with the noble Quran are considered close to the truth, but not quite the truth. The Jesus of Islam is not the Jesus of the Bible. The Book of Lies, the New Testament, is filled with man's alteration and corruption. I have provided ample quotes from Bible theologians and a long list of contradictions that clearly and irrefutably prove this. So now the question to you is, do you honestly call this absurdity about Jesus being a trash-mouthed racist and then changing instantaneously in the Book of Lies as divine revelations from God Almighty? Where is the divine wisdom and perfection in that? I only see double-standard hypocrisy and clear-cut stupidity. Let's just briefly compare the above lies with the divine justice and revelations in the noble Quran, O mankind. We created you from a single pair of a male and a female and made you into nations and tribes, that ye may know each other. Verily the most honored of you in the sight of Allah is the most righteous of you. And Allah has full knowledge and is well acquainted. The Noble Quran, 49:13.